Right now, investigators are combing through the apartment belonging to the man accused of gunning down journalists at a Maryland newspaper. Tonight, police say the accused gunman had a vendetta that started years ago. Good evening. I'm Steve Atkinson.
And I'm Kimberly Hunt. We also know the names of all five people killed, including one born in San Diego. Brian Schlonsky is in the 10 News Live Center now with these breaking developments. Brian.
Well, guys, we are learning that the suspect, Jared Ramos, may have targeted the Capital Gazette over this. It's a defamation lawsuit filed and lost back in 2015. We are learning, too, more about those five journalists killed today, including Wendy Winters, born in San Diego to a U.S. Navy commander.
Investigators working into the night, a huge presence outside what is believed to be the Maryland apartment of the suspect, who police say used a shotgun to take the lives of five journalists. A reporter with the Capital Gazette says that the suspect shot through a glass door into the office. He described the experience as a war zone, tweeting, quote, "There is nothing more terrifying than hearing multiple people get shot while you're under your desk and then hear the gunman reload." The suspect, too, found by police hiding under a desk. Tonight, faces of the victims. Another newspaper, the nearby Baltimore Sun, sharing dozens of memories. Rob Hyacin, described as a mentor to younger journalists. John McNamara, who loved reporting sports. Wendy Winters, a prolific community writer. Rebecca Smith, a new hire with a deep love for family. And Gerald Fishman, a clever and quirky voice. Police say the suspect armed with smoke grenades and that shotgun. Investigators believe that the suspect's rampage followed social media threats directed at the paper for years. Police say he looked for his victims and had a vendetta. The anger seeming to stem from a story that the paper wrote about Jared Ramos stalking a woman. Ramos later sued the paper for defamation and lost. Police clearing up an earlier report that Ramos mutilated his fingers to make it harder for investigators to identify him. Police say that actually a problem with their machine.
Said that they were determined to publish a newspaper the next day despite the shooting in their own newsroom. One reporter tweeting, quote, "Right here, I can tell you this, we are putting out a damn paper tomorrow." And then there's this photo, journalists working outside in the bed of a truck, their newsroom roped off with crime tape. It's already Friday morning now in Maryland. The Capital Gazette following through on their promise, tweeting out this photo of tomorrow's front page. Brian Schlonsky, 10 News.
Brian, thank you. A GoFundMe page has been set up to help the Capital Gazette journalist. In just over 9 hours, more than $50,000. In fact, it's now up to over $52,000 has already been raised for those victims. That money donated will go towards medical bills, funeral costs, and newsroom repairs. Of course, we'll stay on top of this shooting investigation overnight and post new information on 10news.com. We will also have updates on 10 News this morning from 4:30 to 7.